Hey everyone, today I want to share with you the tools that I use as a freelance web designer. I want to share with you not only the design tools, but also the tools that I use to collaborate with clients and do contracts and invoices and all that stuff. I want to preface this by saying I am by no means an expert. I've only been doing web design freelancing full time for about a year now. I do feel a lot more confident with where my process is at now than where it was a few years ago when I was just doing it on the side, but I am still figuring it all out. So take all of this with a grain of salt. Actually, if you are a freelancer, I would love to hear from you and like what tools you use. I'm always looking to improve my processes and I feel like I can learn a lot from you guys. So please leave those in the comments below. So I broke this up into two parts. The first part is gonna be all the tools that I use for the freelancing part of things. And then the second part is gonna be all of the tools that I use for the actual design and like making websites and things like that. And then at the end, I'm gonna have a list of websites that I use for finding fonts and graphics and stock photos and all that kind of stuff. So the first tool I wanna talk about is called Webb. I use this for invoices and payments and it's completely free for what I use it for, other than there is a credit card processing fee. I have been pushing that fee onto the client. Webb has a ton of other features that I'm not using because I don't really have a need for it at this point in my business. All I'm using Webb for is invoicing and getting paid. The second tool I want to talk about is called T-Metric, and I use this for tracking my time. I don't typically charge by the hour when I'm doing a website project, but I do like to keep track of my hours so that I get an accurate idea of how much time I'm putting into a project. And then if I am doing like maintenance activities on a website, then I will charge by the hour. T-Metric is super simple to use. You can have an icon in the top bar of your Mac where you can just click and just start the timer from wherever you are. It's a great free option to just track your time. Next thing I want to talk about is how I do contracts. Take this with a grain of salt because I really don't know what I'm doing. I have a contract template that I got, a web design freelance contract template that I got from a class that I took. So whenever I start a new project, I just take that template and make a copy of it and then fill out the information for this particular client. And then I export it as a PDF. So I'm able to just use Adobe Acrobat to sign the document myself and then send it out to the client to request a signature. I'm always worried that I'm doing the contract wrong. I can't afford to pay for a lawyer for every contract that I create. So I'm really iffy on this part. And if anyone has any better suggestions or any tips on this part of the freelancing process, please share it with me in the comments because I feel like not a lot of people talk about this unless they're trying to sell you like their lawyer services. So I really want to hear like what other people are doing. Next tool I use is Google Drive, just standard. I use Google Drive. I set up a space for each project where I keep a copy of the signed contract. I have a folder for the client to upload images, photos, and things like that for me to use on the website. And then I have another folder for me to share logos and other graphics and things with them. So this is just kind of like the project file hub. And the next tool that I use is called Loom. I was so happy when I saw that it existed. And because it was just like, this is what I've been needing for so long. It's a way for you to send professional videos that you can record of yourself and you can share your screen and send that to whoever you want. So you don't have to have a meeting every time you need to share something with someone or walk them through a design or a website, like whatever it is. You can just create a Loom video and then send them that link. I don't think they need to create a Loom account to view the video, and they can also leave comments and leave reactions. I also use Loom to create tutorial videos where I kind of walk them through their website and how to use it and how to create pages and how to change things. Next tool is a quickie. I use Zoom, of course, just standard. And I do pay for the professional version of Zoom just to not have that 45-minute time limit on meetings. Yeah, it's a business expense, you know. That was a quick one. Last tool that I use for the freelancing side of things is Notion. Notion, of course, if you've watched my videos on here, you've probably heard me mention it before. I love Notion. I use it for so many things. But as it relates to web design freelancing, I use it for creating a client portal. I have a client portal template that I just copy and make a copy of for every new client. And I use this to keep track of my progress on different tasks and also to keep all the links for the project, like the Pinterest board and the Google Drive and all that kind of stuff. I keep everything here. This is like the project hub, not only for me, but also for the client. You can have a database of all of the tasks that you need to accomplish for this project, and you can have different views. You can see it in a timeline view. You can see a board where I have like the status of every task and see like what I'm working on currently. The thing is, most clients won't want to sign up for Notion and create an account and learn how to use this tool. There is an option to make the client portal, make any Notion page visible on the web, like public. I think you have to have the premium version of Notion in order to do that. So I publish the page online, but I only share the link with the client. So in theory, no one else should be able to see this page. It's not indexed by search engines, but I'm still like, I have a little worry in me that like this, like other people can see this. I mean, it's not the end of the world if other people do see it, because there's no private information on here or anything like that, but maybe I'm just paranoid for no reason. But if anyone has a better option, please share it. So those were all the freelancing related tools that I use. So next up, I'm gonna ask you to please like this video if you're finding it helpful at all. It helps a lot. Thank you so much for that. And now let's jump into the tools that I use to actually design and build the website. First one is obvious, Squarespace. I use Squarespace to design websites. I've also used WordPress and I've used Wix, and I only use those if the client has an existing website in those platforms and I'm just doing like a refresh of their website. Then I'll use whatever web builder that they have their website on. But for new websites, I always prefer to use Squarespace. I'm not going to talk too much about that because this video isn't sponsored. Okay, next tool is Figma. Figma is such a great design tool. They have a web client, they have an app. Their collaboration tools in Figma are great. So this is a typical workflow for me. I would create the design in Figma of like the homepage. I would create multiple iterations and then I would pick my favorites and I'll put them in a new clean page, because usually when I'm working in here, it's very messy. I take that clean page with just the versions that I like, and I send the link to the client. I don't typically do the branding part in Figma. I usually use another tool for that, which I'll talk about in a second. So I use Figma for designing the homepage and then also collaborating with the client and having them comment on different parts of the design and tell me like which parts they like and don't like. And then I also go to Loom and I'll record a video to share with them where I walk through the designs. That's like kind of my collaboration process for the initial part of designing like the homepage, which I find is like the most important page because it's designing the whole vibe of the website. Once we kind of settle on an overall vibe for the website homepage, I will then take that into Squarespace, design the homepage, and then do the rest of the website directly in Squarespace. If the client wants me to also do branding and like create a logo for them, then I'll typically do that work in Adobe Illustrator. I pay for the suite of Adobe products, so I have access to all their programs and I take full advantage of that. I use Illustrator for this web design stuff. I use Photoshop for making thumbnails for my videos. I use Premiere Pro for editing the videos. I use Lightroom for like doing quick edits to photos. I use Acrobat for contracts, fill and sign and requesting signatures. I try to use as many of the programs as I can because it is a lot of money to pay for that subscription every month, and I hate that I have to do it, but you know, it is what it is. I use Adobe Illustrator to create the branding concepts and logo and kind of work through that process. I have a video that I'm going to be releasing in the next couple weeks where I walk through the entire branding process for this new client that I'm working with for a nonprofit. So I'm not going to get too deep into that right now. Just look out for that video. I'll link to it here once the video comes out, so you could take a look at that. Like I mentioned, I use Lightroom. That's another tool that I use for editing photos. Sometimes the photos that people send to me are not professional photos, so I need to like straighten them, crop them, bring out the contrast, bring up the brightness, you know, make them look nice. I typically use Lightroom for that because I just find that it's just quicker and easier than Photoshop. I will also sometimes use my iPad with Procreate if I want the branding to have some like hand-drawn elements or hand-drawn logos, things like that. Then I will typically draw it out in Procreate first. Then I'll bring that into Illustrator and vectorize the designs. The last tool that I'm going to share with you that I use is Pinterest. I use Pinterest to get inspiration. I typically would create a board and share this board with the client and have them go and heart the concepts that they like, just so that we're on the same page with the overall like vibe, like what they want the website to look like. So they can go in and add their own pins, you know, and share some pins with me. I feel like a lot of people are familiar with Pinterest and have used Pinterest. And even if they haven't, it's pretty easy to use. So this is a great collaboration tool for getting on the same page with the client, because a lot of times we can have different meanings for the same word, right? Like if I say retro, we could have two different meanings of the word retro, you know? And I've seen that happen before, or like vintage. I've seen people use the word vintage to describe something that I wouldn't use vintage to describe. What I would call retro, they call vintage. Pinterest is a great tool to use for not only gathering inspiration, but also collaborating with the client. Okay, so those are all my tools that I use. Now I'm going to share with you a list of websites that I use for finding fonts and like graphics and stock photos and things like that. I would typically go and try to find a font in Adobe Fonts because I feel like they have a really good collection of fonts. I don't really know how the licensing would work if I have a client that wants to use that font in the future for their own like graphics in like Canva and things like that, that they would make themselves. I want to give them a brand font that they can continue to use with their brand. And I know most people don't have a license to use Adobe Fonts. So just to avoid all of that complication, I just would only use Adobe Fonts when it makes sense to do so. Otherwise, I use these other resources to find fonts. So the first one is Google Fonts, but all of their fonts are open source, which is great. They're free, but I feel like they don't have a huge variety of fonts. They're all pretty basic, but I do use them on occasion. So there's that one. There's also Creative Market, which I feel like has so many great fonts, and they're all pretty reasonably priced. I think they're between maybe $15 to $40-ish for each font. CreativeFabrica.com is another one that has a lot of fonts and graphics that you could purchase, and they're pretty cheap. They're even cheaper than Creative Market, I think. I just learned about this website for this project that I'm working on right now for a client, where I was looking for like a handwritten cursive font. They have a lot of those like script fonts, and I don't know if they're always this cheap, but in the past few days that I've been using it, they've had this crazy sale. So the fonts are only like $1 or $2 or something like that. For stock photos, I use Unsplash, Pexels, and Pixabay. I think that you have to be very careful with stock photos because I really don't like the look of websites that have a lot of very obvious stock photos. You know, it feels so inauthentic to me. But I understand, like, you can't always have original photos for your websites, so stock photos are necessary in some cases. I know that there are other higher quality stock photo websites out there, like Death to Stock or Stocksy, but they're just too expensive for me right now with the websites that I'm working on. They are so unique and cool, and I want to use them, but I just can't afford, and I feel like my clients can't afford to absorb those costs. But I do use these three websites because they're free. One thing I found recently that you can do on Pexels is you can search for images by a particular color, which is very helpful. I think that they probably have more photos for the colors that are already pre-chosen, you know, that are right here on the filter. But if you want, you can give it a shot and put your brand color in there as well, and or whatever color you're looking for. So that's pretty much it. I think that's pretty much it.